The other day, I was talking with a friend of mine about some of the newer tech that has come out over the past decade or so that neither one of us have bought into yet. We were mostly talking about tablets because that's something that we're both actually kind of interested in buying, since the gap between thin, light, portable laptops and high-end tablets has pretty much been bridged at this point. Like, if you look at models like the iPad Pro and the Tab S8, and you pair those with a keyboard case, it could be an amazing thin client laptop. So that's some tech that I might get soon, but there's a whole sector of tech that we were talking about that we're both kind of skeptical of for some time now, and that is the wearable devices. So Apple Watches are probably the most popular kind of wearable devices. And of course, Samsung, they also have a watch as well, and so does Google, now that they acquired Fitbit. And there's some other brands as well, some lesser known ones, but these are the mainstream wearable device brands. And I've even heard of people taking these and modding them, like putting gold or jewel encrusted cases on those smartwatches so that you can count your steps and show off your wealth at the same time, because that's what watches are used for these days. Who wants a watch to just do something boring like tell the time? Now, like I said, I don't have any wearable smart devices, but the issue for me is not that I don't want to buy something that I don't have a need for, because I actually do think that these smartwatches are useful, especially for fitness progress tracking, because I think that the step counters, for example, those are much more accurate than counting steps with your phone. But a lot of these watches also have heart rate monitors, basically to monitor it via your pulse. And tracking your pulse is a way more accurate way to figure out the calories that you are burning compared to just tracking your steps, especially if most of your exercise is coming from lifting weights. Because if you think about it, when you do a heavy set of squats, for example, your heart rate is going to go up quite a bit. You're doing a lot of work, and that activity is going to burn a lot of calories. But a step counter is really only going to count when you're walking the weight out and then walking it back in. And even then, it's not accounting for the fact that there's hundreds of pounds on your shoulders. And so traditional step counters, they're not the best way to really track calories that are being burned or the amount of work that you're doing. And also, those traditional step counters can way overestimate your steps. If, say, you're skateboarding down a hill, you might be moving, right? The accelerometer is detecting movement, but you're basically just standing still, not burning a whole lot of calories. Another great thing that these wearable devices do is track your sleep, which is the third most important thing for fitness behind diet and exercise. Because whether you want to burn fat or gain muscle, making sure that you get enough sleep is essential to do that. And honestly, even if you aren't into fitness, it's good just for general health reasons to know what your average heart rate is or what it is under stress when you're doing some work without having to go to the doctor, or to be able to see a rough idea of how many calories you're burning and that you're getting a good night's sleep. So when you add up all the health benefits, I think that you could even argue that these wearable devices are more useful than smartphones, especially since they make smartwatches with built-in LTE now that can do at least all the productive stuff like texting, email, phone calls, and digital payments without needing to have a phone on you. But the problem with most of these watches, just like most consumer technology, is that they are absolutely proprietary, and in a lot of cases with these devices, they also spy on you. We know at this point that these big tech companies make a lot of their money from harvesting consumer data and then using that for targeted advertising. So you've got to think that if there's a watch that is tracking your steps, tracking the notifications and text messages that you're getting to your phone, and it's even tracking your heartbeat while you sleep, this is one of the only devices that's literally going to track data from you 24/7, that these companies are going to milk that for its information. So Apple Watches with proprietary watchOS, they are out for me. So that leaves the world of Wear OS, at least as far as the mainstream smartwatches go. Now, Wear OS is mostly open source. It's actually based on Android, And the Wear OS ecosystem is pretty much the same as the Android ecosystem in the sense that all of these manufacturers are using the same OS, but then they are adding a bunch of proprietary bloatware that tracks you on top of it. So you can theoretically remove this extra bloat just like you can on Android phones if you unlock the bootloader and then install a custom ROM. Or if you root it, you may be able to disable the specific spy components, proprietary stuff that they added in. But this can be a bit of a challenge on smartwatches because how do you actually go about connecting a cable to these watches in order to send that data and those commands to them? Sure, these watches have charging cables, but you can't always communicate with the watches over that cable to flash a custom ROM to the device. In some cases, you have to take the watch apart and then connect those wires to the contacts that are on the board of the watch. And of course, taking the watch apart like this could damage it, void your warranty, absolutely, and make it no longer waterproof if it isn't sealed back up properly. And even for watches like the TicWatch Pro or the Fossil Gen 6, where you can send ADB commands and unlock commands or commands to unlock the bootloader over the same USB cable that's used to charge it, this whole process of installing a custom ROM and unlocking the bootloader, relocking the bootloader, is still too technical for most people. It's at least as difficult as, well, installing a custom ROM on your phone, which is already too difficult for most end users to do. Although, since these smartwatches are cheaper and typically don't hold a lot of important data on them, at least not as much as people's smartphones do, then it might be easier for people to, I guess, work up the courage to try and install a custom ROM that's not going to have all the spyware in it onto their watch. And if they break their watch, then it's not as big a deal as breaking their phone. So these are probably not the best option for smartwatches because they don't have sane defaults, or at least they don't have nice defaults where they're not going to spy on the end user. But luckily, there are some options like the Pine Time from Pine 64 that are truly open source with open firmware, and we know that they're not going to be harvesting customer data. And these watches are also a whole lot cheaper than a lot of these smartwatches that run Wear OS or Watch OS, which is Apple's OS. But it's a similar situation with these watches to what we see with the Pine phone versus Android phones. So you get more freedom, but fewer features. There's no LTE option for these watches yet, so you really do have to use them with your phone for all of the features to work. There is a step counter and a heart rate monitor in the Pine Time, but I've heard that it's not that great compared to the mainstream watches, and there's no sleep tracking capability right now. And there's another project that I just became aware of today, the ZS Watch. So this is an open source Zephyr-based smartwatch. This is a smartwatch that somebody built from scratch, both hardware and the software. I believe they 3D printed the case, but they're planning on redoing it soon with a CNC machine so that it looks a little bit nicer. Built from scratch, it has an accelerometer for the step counter. It's got a pulse tracker. It's got a vibration motor, pop-up notifications for when you get text messages or emails, etc. And of course, it tells you the time. So these are just a couple of the more open source watch options out there, smartwatch options. Which one do you think is going to be best for you? An Android watch with a custom ROM, a Pine Time, or just building your very own watch with custom hardware and custom software? Personally, if I were to go the like custom from scratch route, I think that I would just ditch the whole idea of a watch and go for a Pip-Boy, something with a screen the size of like an iPod 4, and I think that that would be pretty cool. And I think with a bigger screen and just a bigger overall device, you could fit better hardware in there, probably a bigger battery, and ultimately get more features out of it. But let me know which of those watch options you think would be best for you. Like and share to Hack the Algorithm, follow me on Odyssey, and have a great day.